Boitiwa.
Even before becoming a saint, Pope John Paul II was incredibly popular around the world. Now, Polish journalist Paulina Guzik explores the roots of this popularity. Her documentary on John Paul II dives into his philosophical thought and his theology of the body, showing their continued impact on people today.
And many months before I had this idea of producing this movie, George Weigel told me that we, the Poles, have to remember at the centenary of John Paul II that the Pope is not only the emotional Pope, that the Pope that we loved so much as Poles, but that we need to show the Pope who is a great thinker, a great humanist, a great philosopher, theologian of the body, the great communicator and the great inspirator. And this is I Like to See the Sunrise.
The documentary aims to give the audience an understanding of John Paul II's thinking and teachings, which are often overlooked because of his iconic image.
In some wonderful plans of God's providence, Karol Wojtyła, John Paul II, thanks to the help of God's grace, everything we do in 10, maybe 20 or 30%, he managed to live 100%. He did this in some human divine life, and this is the miracle of John Paul II. We call it holiness.
The film includes original, less-known footage and photos of John Paul II. It also draws upon the knowledge of a number of people familiar with his life, including his biographer, George Weigel, and his personal secretary, Cardinal Stanisław Dziwisz.
It's not fiction, it's a documentary, and that's why this film is a message with the authenticity of the testimonies, but above all, with quotes of the Holy Father himself. These quotes are bringing tears, they settle in our memory, and it's good that these films are produced.
Producers are hoping the documentary will have an impact not only in Poland, but around the world. Preparations for the U.S. premiere event, initially planned for May 2020, have been suspended due to the coronavirus. Nonetheless, producers are still hoping to release the film to the wider television audience in North America.